No, I know. I'm not looking for that.
No, lawyers in solidarity. I'm a lawyer to start the case. But we have recalled lawyers to start the case. Yesterday, I went to a lab around 1 day. I buy an apartment of my or hell. I want to tell my car. Then I bet you about the Nigerian hell. So here I will get an easy way to cheer. He only in the car and because even if we watch it, they get very equal. That means they turn the go where Yara go further. Oh, no, but so here, who knows a lot of time, or maybe I lost some of our lawyers who do to that. Oh, when I regiment time when yesterday I met her here.
The person the British government gave letter to represent him wasn't even allowed to him. The question I'm asking about this is not kind of and what does my question is what does Buhari want to achieve by this? What do I mean by that? The rules of faith trials is very simple. What are you hiding? If you feel a man have done something wrong, you try him publicly because you have your case. We're not going to have a repeat of what happened in Kenya. Have the journalists, any of the journalists, had the courage to ask the attorney general, to ask President Mohamed Bazoum, to proudly tell people what happened in Kenya? It was a rogue operation, but there will be justice on that. Maybe just 1 year and become a woman. How he was adopted in that camp, the kind of beating he was, and the kind of was given under that camp, where he was taken and nearly executed. Today, the Kenyan government said that they were not aware of him. Some officials of the Kenyan government, including the secret police, were part of the operation. And he was abducted and brought here. Yes, people will say it doesn't matter how a suspect is brought to court. No, it matters. Because this will remind us the kind of thing the prince of Saudi would do to Khashoggi in Turkey. The kind of things India mean of Nkurunziza would do to people who oppose them in different countries. But there is one thing I want everybody to take from here. We are focusing on what is happening today. But we are not focusing on how we got to this particular point. Any messenger of truth, anybody who desires justice, like I do, will understand that the events of today were all predicted. You saw the injustice. You saw the lopsidedness of actions that was taken by the president. From the very moment he was warning. From the issue of 95% to 5%, the president carried on with divisive policies, which you know, hate was promoted, divisions was promoted. And all the people who are complaining today, what did they say? When there was those killings in Nimbo, those ones in Okigwe, those ones in Delta, where people were killed and raped, what did you tell the president? What did you demand? All of you were here when we even asked for a change of the service chief. For us to be able to bring proactive action. Was there anything that was done?
No.
Was there anything that was done?
No.
Now, at the time the attorney general rushed to go while facing this guy.
Yes, sir.
And proscribed the iPhone. Was there any killing?
No.
Is there any confusion?
No.
These actions are promoted by hate. That is why, with what is now already happening in court, when you don't allow the lawyers of the defense, the people they want the defendant to go in, when the court will give order that 3-4 people can visit him and they get to DSS and they are screened down and they cannot enter. When our respected traditional rulers will sit under the sun and they will not be allowed to enter a court for a trial that is supposed to be open, free and fair, I begin to ask myself, can there be justice that will come out of this charade?
No.
Starting from the refusal of the president to address the insecurity and the killing that was ravaging the East then, going by his decision to also, more importantly, even after the arrest of Nnamdi Kanu, ask you all one question. What efforts have the government done in trying to address those grievances that raised to the rise of those agitations? If a man is honest and he truly desires peace for his people, what will he have done? He would have started the process of peace building, reaching out to people and building confidence. But he doesn't care. He just wants to keep him. And then you want to try him. Why do we need to try him at federal high court? He should take him to Daura and try him. Let's note where he's trying him. Because you can't call this a federal high court of the republic. And a citizen is accused of an offense. And you cannot even allow him to have a fair trial. Neither do you obey the orders of court. And that is why my message is very simple. The president should take the path of peace and negotiation. Let's find an end to this. Let us find an end to this. Which is granting bail, moving from DSS to police custody, and granting bail and pursue the path of peace, reconciliation, and negotiation. This trial to me, to God who made me, was unnecessary, was avoidable. And this trial is baseless. And it is in the interest of peace and unity and stability that this trial of Nnamdi Kanu be discontinued. And I say this as a messenger of truth, one who always pursues and desires truth. After all, you people were here when the DSS charged me for treason of trying to overthrow the government. Did I overthrow the government?
No.
Did I?
No.
Did he change my views on issues?
No.
No, because if you believe in truth and justice, it does not matter how many times you are tried or how many times you are arrested, you always pursue truth. And all I say, and I want the media to follow to ask these issues, that if after the arrest, there is agitation by citizens who have rights to agitate self-defense, have you made any effort to address the imbalance in the country?
No.
Have you even made any effort to implement the report on restructuring by his party?
No.
So you can see that this trial is not about the good of anybody. To me, it's hate. And it's about denying a man, throwing a man at his back. From the way he was even adopted. Ask yourself, why has the government not boldly told you how he was brought here? When Obama or whatever went to kill Osama, you saw the footage of what happened.
Yes.
So if you say what you did there, you are proud of it, say it now. Because it was a rogue oppressor. But that would be an issue for another day. What I'm saying is that there is no fair trial procedure going on. And that is why I came here. The other day I came, they will not allow me to enter. I said, do I look like a terrorist? I'm going to bomb the court. Our traditional rulers are under the sun. Look at Ezebu Olodum sitting right there. Look at our former governor Chukwuemeka sitting right under the sun. They are humiliating our people. And they are making us feel we are not wanted. And that is why I said, let the president open the court and allow Nigerians to witness these proceedings. And if I were to advise, discontinue this trial, grant him bail, and take the path of peace, negotiation, and reconciliation. That is the easy part. Instead of wasting so much, I was coming here, I saw Navy, I saw Air Force, I saw all security agencies all over the place. We need these men in the field to help us quell this rising insecurity in the country. There is a lot of challenges that need to be addressed. And if you try a man without giving him justice and favor, that trial is nonsense.
Yes.
So I am here to say that this ongoing trial and the denial of access to justice is unfair, and that has made this trial a charade. And I know, and I plead with Justice Mutalanya, you don't continue a proceedings if your orders are not obeyed. If you believe as an agent of justice that your orders are not obeyed, you suspend this. You stop it for now. Because the other day they gave the order, you saw what happened. They were not allowed. They nominated Ezebu to go there. He did not go. Now today again, he came with it. Okay, look at as old as Ezebu is and Ezebu, are they going to attack the court? Are they going to do anything? They will not now. So why all this? This is unnecessary. And that is why I said it's very painful. I'm not going to force my way through. But I want the whole world to know that this trial is not a trial. This is like a family guard. It's not a trial. Are you getting me? My name is Ikenga Imo Ugochinyere. I'm the spokesperson of the opposition coalition And also, I want to say this, and that is why, on our own part, we have taken this matter to international community. How did you, in the first place, sneak into Kenya, adopted a man with rogue organization, people who are semi-terrorists, nearly killed him in Kenya, smuggled him into Nigeria, and then you want people to overlook that aspect? Is this the first time this is happening? In 1984, what happened to Umaru Biko when he was put in a crane in London? Are we going to turn our country into a rogue nation? No. And then what he went to, how did he have heart attack? Was he not when the people who adopted him in Kenya turned the generator on his face that he had that heart attack? Does he used to have that medical history before? So when you do all these things, and then you don't apply the same energy to the bandits and the killer herdsmen that is ravaging our farmland, you don't use the same method to go to Niger to adopt them, or go to the forest to adopt them, and you adopt this man, and you want me to believe that you want to try this man fail. I'll be a fool to believe that. This trial is baseless to me. As long as I'm concerned, discontinue this trial, pursue the path of peace and reconciliation. Address these grievances. These grievances, are they not supposed to be addressed? Lopsidedness in all the actions, issues of fiscal federalism. If these issues were addressed, will Nnamdi Kanu have had more people listening to his message? It was because you refused to address those issues. That was why at the time he spoke, when most of our Eastern brothers refused to speak for our people, that his message had a solid belief by people. Yes. So the key to addressing these issues is to give him bail, is to ensure that you go back to the table with everybody and then find a common ground so that we can renegotiate and find a way to live or not to live. It's very simple. And this is issues of fundamental human rights, right to self-defense and so on and so forth. Or were they happy when those things were happening in the forest? And when you do this down in the east, you don't use the same energy up in the north. Nobody is slave to anybody. And there's one message I want you to take home. Most people who have dictatorial tendencies, whether in Nigeria or the world, they refuse to learn from history. Nobody has ever won this war of dictatorship. If not, Hitler would have won it. Idi Amin would have won it. Inquisitor Burundi would have won it. What they call him, the one from Zaire, Congo, Mobutu Sese Seko would have won it. So nobody wins it. Because it is unfair, it is injustice. It doesn't survive, it doesn't last forever. So I am here today and appealing to them, if for anything, allow people to even assess the court. Allow our judiciary members to assess the court. Allow the lawyers to assess the court. Attorney General can knock on with 9 lawyers and their people, and then you want to screen down those lawyers. Okay, why are they hiding that they don't want the white man to enter, the one from Mr. Bruce from the US and the one the British government sent? Is there anything fishy about this thing? There's no place in the world people are trying to write this. So this is unfair, and all I'm asking as a messenger of truth is justice in this trial process, if it must go on. If not, this thing is going to produce an already known outcome.
No problem. So, you know, we have kind of. We are frustrating Nigerian lies. This is why phone is very good. So, if they like now, all this is done about. You know how many viewers? Yes. So, let them do whatever they want to do.
Who are you?
Maroni.
I was not even allowed to enter. But what pending was not because I was not allowed to enter. Not even allowed to enter inside the country premises. A 90-year-old man. What danger does he present? I was shocked also to see Mr. Bruce, the American lawyer, was not even allowed to be part of the proceeding. The person the British government gave a letter here was not even allowed to enter. I asked myself,
Holy, 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 holy Is another savior.